Headbands and mullets, they're coming back.
Coming back, come
I'm
on.
Bringing them back.
Come on, bro.
How's that?
But I'm still trying not to throw up for my training.
I know, it's so hot today.
That's a true nine. We're gonna go, shit. We're gonna go 402. So three reds, a black, a 1.25, and a smaller. That gives me a, looks like a bit of variant. Okay. 1896 total for my fucking peak week. That's whack.
Huh?
For like doubles and singles.
That ain't bad, dog. That's not bad, especially.
How we feeling, big dog?
Fucking hot.
What a fucking day.
Fucking summertime here in South Texas, man. It's fucking hot.
Yeah, dude.
I think it's, what, like 102 right now?
Hell yeah.
It feels like it. It's definitely in the hundreds. 96, but it feels like 103. Damn. Fucking humidity's a bitch, bro.
Like you, papa.
Como andas, chulo?
Yeah, bro, how was training?
It was decent. Decent given the situation. I definitely didn't prepare for the heat like I should have. Only had a little bit of water, not a lot of food. So the heat definitely played a factor, but still hit a good squat single. Still hit a good bench single. It's not a good way to end the week. We're about 2 weeks out, so it's just about staying healthy and just about carrying this peak all the way to the meet. Hopefully we can come back with that championship.
Hey, you ready for Vegas though, right?
Yeah, man, just ready. This is the quickest turnaround I've done between meets. So we did the Philly meet and then we flipped around and got ready for Nationals. But overall, body's feeling great. Body doesn't hurt. Weight's a little low, but we just gotta pick it up here in the next couple weeks.
Yeah.
Other than that, my elbows are fine, my knees are fine, my back is fine. And when everything feels 100%, it's gonna be a fucking show, man.
Fuck,
that's it.
Yeah.
Just gotta make sure we go stay in the pocket for the last couple training sessions we got. All the heavy shit is done. And we just gotta make sure we stay healthy. Don't do nothing stupid to ruin all the progress we have made. And just ride this peak until the end of the meet. Then we can celebrate, take a nice long off season. That's the plan.
Oh yeah, bro.
So started working out. Started working out when I was like 13 playing football. And of course, you know, here in South Texas, you gotta play football. And then I lost my full-time job. Started working at a commercial gym like in my hometown. And like I wanted to be a bodybuilder, so I started getting bigger, started putting on size. And then I realized I was not put on this earth to have a six-pack, and I was fine with that. So then I did one bench like heavy day and benched like 375. And there was this old head power lifter behind the counter that was like, hey man, let me put you through like an 8-week prep and see what happens. Like just to see like how it goes. So I started doing that. I started watching, you know who Strength Cartel is? Started watching their videos. Started getting more into powerlifting, and then I did one meet, and I did okay. I mean, like I totaled like 1395 or some shit like that. It's bullshit meet, but like after that first meet, like you just get bit by the bug and you just start fucking.
You get addicted.
Because you want to do better than the meet before, then you want to do better than that meet, then you want to do better than that meet. Then I hired a coach and started taking it 100% more seriously, and then that's when everything just started like skyrocketing and shit. And then I hit a little plateau after my meet in August. I hit a little plateau where I was hitting the same numbers every day. Prep was feeling like shit. I didn't want to powerlift anymore. So then I made a drastic decision and changed coaches, and then everything just started fucking skyrocketing again. And now I'm sitting, which I found out a couple days ago, I am number 2 in the nation right now and number 1 in the state. So just gotta stay healthy, man.
So what's one lesson that has stuck with you on your entire weight fitness journey?
Trust the process.
Literally.
Trust the process and don't get caught up in other people's shit. Like, you get caught up in other people's shit, you get caught up in other people's numbers. So like, everybody that starts powerlifting, they want to compare themselves to the number one dude who's in their weight class. So like, for me, it would be Big Ray Williams and Jesus, and it's like, those dudes are squatting 1,000 fucking pounds and benching 600 pounds. And like, a lot of people get caught up in those numbers and like, why am I not there and why am I not here? But you just gotta learn to trust the process and not get caught in other people's shit. Because if you focus on other people's shit, then you're not gonna have 100% focus in what you're doing and what you have the potential to do. And if you like have, I used to be really bad. I would have one shitty training session and I'd be like, man, this shit's not for me. I'm fucking weak. Like, and then in reality, I only squatted like 10 pounds less than what I usually squat on a Monday or whatever. But in my mentality, it was like, yeah, man, I'm shit. I'm not gonna be good. I'm never gonna be good. It's not gonna work out. I should just fucking quit. But then as long as you trust the process and just stay focused on whatever you're doing, eventually everything starts coming together. Everything starts clicking. Everything starts working the way that the universe is supposed to make it work. If you're meant to do something great, you're gonna do something great. But as long as you bust your ass and as long as you do what you need to do, you'll be able to reach that destination. No matter how fucking long it takes, it could take you 5, 10, 15 years to get there. Like, I've been powerlifting for going on 5 years now, and this is my first time being in primetime nationals in the number one slot. Last time I did nationals, I finished like 19th. The year before that, I didn't even go to nationals because my total wasn't good enough. So this is my first time being like the top dude at the list. So it's all about just trusting the process and just knowing that for every shitty day, you're gonna have a great day after that. Like today was a shit day. My numbers that I've hit already at this point in my last prep, this was a shit day technically. But I mean, I still squatted 727, I still benched 452, and I pulled 700 pounds like 2 days ago. So it's not like, in the grand scheme, it was a shit day, but in the way I'm feeling and the way we are in prep, it was a great week. So, I mean, it's just trying to keep a positive mindset, try not to get down on yourself too much, and then you'll get there eventually. The beautiful thing about powerlifting, you got nothing but time. Nothing but time to get to wherever it is you want to get. You want to get to a 500 squat, you got all the time in the world. 300 bench, all the time in the world. 500 deadlift, all the time in the world. You just gotta trust the process, ride the wave, man. That's it. Whoa. Oh,
okay. Okay.
Double cheeked up.
Cafe dog.
Ah damn, patron, bro, eating them shorts up, bro.
Oh, you ahead. How you doing, big dog? Hey, introduce yourself real quick for the people. I know you knew. And last week I made a mistake and I was recording in slow mo, so we couldn't
introduce you
last week. No, we good. I think we good. Yeah, it looks like the mic is on. The mic is on.
Alright, Hector Alvarez, one of the newer Hectors working here at Lift ATX. There's another Hector, not to be confused, that's Hector Heck. I'm still Hector Heck. Been coming here since we've been open, down almost 100 pounds, still going. Y'all see me, give me a high. I like to eat, so bring me food, we'll be good friends.
Yeah, so just know, if you hear them Latin jams,
oh,
it's either Gabe. Gabe has a different vibe though, but if you got the Romanticas going, hey, it's my boy Hector, still Heck.
Heartbreak kid over here. No, Lover boy.
Lover boy Heck. Hell yeah. So if y'all hear the romantic Latin music, you know who it is.
Did you not brush your teeth this morning?
Goddamn. I brushed them twice.
I'm gonna take it though.
That shit was so easy, bro.
Okay. Bet. Yeah, so that's you right there.
All right. Bet. It's going down.
What'd you you say, Danny?
You need to add more weight. It's ridiculous. It's embarrassing the weight over here. You can't even turn gravity on. What the fuck?
Next.
Heck.
Heck, what you hitting?
497. 49. Hey, you gotta make it a 9.
Nice and tight.
Make it look like an 8. And then Drew's gonna say the infamous words. We're going up.
Dang, bro, baby. Just make it 500, dog.
I already hit 500. It's supposed to be a 9. That hole was for a 10.
I'm ready. I'm ready for you.
Fuck, chill. I'm a lion. I don't know how it looked. It felt good, shit. You gotta watch that bitch.
What's that bitch?
Damn. Shit. Damn.
What you like?
Fuck yeah. That don't move. Shit.
What the hell was that, Danny?
Yeah. It was everything wrong that could have gone wrong in the same moment.
Oh, goddamn. Yeah. No, but what is that? What is this exercise?
Just loading the sandbag over the bar.
A la verga.
Yeah.
It looks exhausting.
What?
It looks exhausting.
It's definitely the least fun you could have in any given moment. In time or existence, for sure, yeah.
God damn. All right, bro. I'm going to let you rest then, goddamn.
Yeah. Got one more.
Eight and a half.
That's what I say, 8.5.
That was my...
That was good, that was right.
That was my sandbag.
I don't know, bro. 8.5, bro.
That was right on pocket.
Heck said 8.5, bro.
That felt great.
That was good.
Heck said he wants more, bro.
We're chill, we're good. Stay in pocket. Stay in pocket.
Fuck y'all. Y'all be staying, you're making me go up.
That felt good.
A 6. What? Y'all telling me I'm sandbagging. Y'all fucking sandbagging.
It feels good to get that.
Let him know. Like, don't go to like 540 or something.
This is how we gotta do Heck. He can't know the weight that we're putting on the bar. They're getting his head and shit.
Heck or Andrew?
Heck. No, Heck.
Is he going up?
Yeah, no. He did, with 497.
Is this what y'all are talking about?
Yeah, this is what we're talking
collar.
About.
We have the 0.25 collars.
Like, this is what they do with me, with Drew, with Heck.
Why they're not a comp collar? Because they're
black. Wait, baby.
Y'all ain't telling me?
No. Oh,
shit. Don't be calculating.
I need a song, goddamn.
What?
He always be acting like he don't care. He cares a lot about this shit. I'm excited for him. Yeah, he's mad. He can get mad at us.
What's he want?
No. My angry music. Fuck the world music. That rope. Both sit down.
I'm behind you.
Oh yeah!
I told you, my nigga.
You're right. I was wrong.
That's 509. I said 515, but I'm digging.
That's yeah. 9. Damn.
Fuck
it
up, Denny's.
Happy. Now he's happy.
Yeah.
Seen that face before.
Yeah.
Now he's happy.
All right, let's go. When you don't have a bottle opener, show it on time.
Hey, how'd it go today, bro? How was
today
training?
Today was good, man. Today was a vibe. Today was a good day. We fucked around and tried to find our RP9. It's awesome to see like our homies get stronger, man. It's dope as shit. Today was a good day. The weather was beautiful. We had a little cold front come in. It's just dope to see everybody get stronger, man. It was a good day. Good deadlifting day. Everybody's healthy. Josh is 2 weeks out from nationals. He's feeling healthy. Come on. You know we keep the vibes going, man. It's a good day. Now we just now we're chilling, enjoying the last of this nice weather until the next few days. I know we're gonna be expecting a lot of rain, but it was a good day today, man. Good day, good Sunday.
Hell yeah.
But my grandma's lived in the same house that I grew up in. Me, my brother, my sister, my mom, my aunt, my uncles, like my grandpa. It was the house that we grew up in. It was the only house we knew. It was grandma's house, right?
Yeah.
And this, maybe like my street, Townsend. A good friend of mine used to live right there, maybe right here. And then like we used to come, and then like when it got nighttime, we'd get scared, so we'd have to sprint all the way to our house, because you thought when you were a kid, you thought something was gonna get you.
Yeah.
So we had to sprint our ass home. And I was a fat kid. I thought I was running fast. I wasn't running fast. But I remember, damn, people live here. No, this is my house with this yellow. Damn, that's new. This yellow fence is new. But this is my house right here. This is the house I grew up in. Damn, somebody's already here. They put up a fence and shit.
Damn. Hey, dude, you think they're gonna let me in with my camera?
So one way to find out. We don't know these rules in good old Corpus Christi.
A ver. Andamos en Freedom Fitness. Ahoy!
Goddamn. Henry, alright. Hey, is this part of your diet, Momo? My grandma going off protocol, bro. She called me, she said, Mijito. Yeah, Momo, I'm on the way. I want you to pick me up a water burger. I got you, Momo. I got you. Diet Coke.
What else there for you?
Oh, I'm sorry, a Dr. Pepper.
Okay.
And that's going to be it.
Would you like...
My grandma called. She knows what's up.
Hey.
Mijito, I want a water burger. She knows the doctors aren't supposed to. She knows she's not supposed to eat water burger. Yeah, have a good day. See?
Voila.
Again, for my grandma.
Hey!
Hey, Mijito.
What's up, Momo? I got your water burger. I'm good. Give me a hug. I want to introduce you to somebody. This is Carlos. Have you talked to Uncle Joe? No?
I'm about to introduce y'all to my brothers, the closest people in my circle. And they're all assholes. I love them to death, but they're the closest people in my hometown circle. I went to high school with them. Some of them I went to middle school with. We all played football together.
they're all big motherfuckers, and I'm afraid that this guy's gonna get his ass kicked if he talks too much shit. But these are like my family. I rarely get to see this, so like, long story short, silver lining, one of our best friends lost his mom, so we're down here. We came to the Rosary, and the silver lining is I finally, you know, it brings everybody together, so I get to see my guys, my homies, my brothers that I haven't seen. They're all family guys and stuff, so I haven't seen them in a very long time. So we're all about to drink and eat some dinner, and Los is gonna get to meet him too, so it'll be fun. Valerie.
What?
Valerie, Jaime. Gabriel.
Gabriel.
You know, might have met Josh.
Gabriel, Josh, what up, G?
What
up, Josh? Yeah. There we go. What's up, G? Carlos, bro. Hell yeah.
I don't be too honest with this.
What's up, baby?
What's up, bro? How you doing? Nah, be honest as fuck. Tell me the whole story.
You want it all?
Tell me everything, bro. All the dirty secrets. Please.
Hey,
it go hard?
Very hard.
Bandas, seafood, bandas.
So boat net is like our old school hood treat. Like you're talking about, you walk up. There's a PVC pipe that you order through.
Cowbell and a PVC pipe.
Yeah. God,
then I'm not
a doorbell.
100% sure that drugs also were in exchange for that.
Sold in the back.
Yeah, drugs sold in the back.
And then it's the only fried shrimp that you can eat. That you eat the shrimp and the tail.
A la verga.
You get everything.
Hey, when you grow up poor like that, you don't waste anything.
No, hell no.
It's all games.
Nobody remembers that.
Genuine
man, y'all are 50.
Tattoo, and it's a tramp stamp.
Nah.
He's got a tramp stamp.
He still has the tattoo.
He got the matching one on his truck. It was the summer of 99.
It literally was, yeah, I think it was.
Summer of 99, and Godsmack was consuming
the
world.
It wasn't Godsmack.
It was a son, it was.
It was a son.
He got a tribal son on his belly button.
It was the same year Abel got his.
Right here, took 2 seconds.
Yeah, that's me. Yeah, fucking
bruh.
Assholes.
Bruh.
Okay.
Gotten very dangerous. Man, but that shit was like that when I was growing up as a kid. We just didn't know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You don't really see it as a kid.
Straight from the road, right back to Corpus Christi, and we got a new machine in. Can y'all guess? Any guesses what it is? Any guesses? We've been waiting about 3-4 months for it. Pretty.
Out to this thing.
Be the first one.
Come on, show us how it's done. All right. How do you grow glutes?
How you grow your glutes, y'all. You get your Crocs on. You put them in sport mode.
Sport mode. Got it.
Sport mode, you know what I'm saying?
Okay,
don't forget your Lift ATX gibbet. All right. Then you buckle up, you know. Click it, don't tick it. You know what I'm saying?
Buckle it up.
Size. Okay. You get your upper back on this.
Okay.
On this joint, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. One leg.
I.
The other leg. But then, you know what I'm saying? To get both cheeks.
Double cheeked up on a Tuesday.
This is how you get caked up.
Caked
up. Hey. Get
that face. There you go. Hey, don't make that face when you do it.
And then, you get nalga bites.
All
right, that wraps up another vlog. Man, these weeks go by so fast. So we went to Corpus to go visit one of my best friends whose mom passed away. Los got to see some of my best friends, my core group. And now we're right back to work. Josh came through earlier in the week to hit some heavy ass squats. He's about 2 weeks out from Nationals. Opie's about 2 weeks out from Nationals. We just got back from Corpus. It's, what day is it, Tuesday?
Tuesday.
We got our booty builder. We've been waiting about 3 months for that mofo. It's here, it's ready for y'all to build some glutes. You'll see some videos I'm gonna post on IG about it and stuff, but this is a really great machine. We're happy that we got it, because, and now merch drop is coming up in three days
for the vlog.
Oh yeah, 3 days, because by y'all watching this Wednesday. So damn, merch drop Saturday 10 a.m don't be late, man. Get on y'all's mouses, get on y'all's computers, have the link ready.
Stop.
But man, this merch shelf is gonna be crazier. Just the materials are better. Just be ready for this shit, man. It's gonna be fucking amazing stuff.
We're wanting to really like one up ourselves every single time we do a new merch drop, and I feel like this is really setting a precedent for what's to come.
Yo, y'all aren't ready. I'm taking it up a notch, man. Straight up, it's as simple as I can say it. Like, we're taking it a step up.
All right, y'all. Remember, every Wednesday comes out a new vlog. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. That's it.
And with strength and community, community and strength.